peeps in a tinted Jeep with the spinning feet, doors off, denim seats. All women flirt, all women cheat, but you ain't gotta creep when you know we doing weed. Shit, I might spend a week down in Miami Beach with a hella freak.
What is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Ask Me Anything. I get so happy when I get to focus on and talk about Italian brands, whether it be Zergioff or Nasamato or Oda Italy. You know, I'm 3/4 Sicilian. I'm very proud of the Italian products. And I've always said that when Italians want to do something and put their full commitment behind it, they do it better than anyone else in the world. I mean, look at cars and Lamborghinis and Ferraris. Look at wine, you know, Barolos and Amarones. Look at fashion, Gucci, Prada, Versace, Armani, Zegna, Loro Piana, Brioni. Look at food, you know, pizza, pasta, tiramisu. Look at coffee, espresso, cappuccino. Look at art, Michelangelo, Da Vinci. And look at fragrances. And Italians are really starting to be a fragrance in a presence in the niche market as well. All the brands that are out there. And I'm going to be talking about more of these in the future, of course. But today I'm going to cover one that doesn't get an ounce of the love that it deserves, the house of Lorenzo Villarisi. Now, guys, when I started doing my show over a year ago, and I had six subscribers, I wrote to every niche house out there, and I said, could I get some samples? You know, I'm more than happy to pay. Some never responded. Some charged me for sample sets. Some said they didn't have sample sets. And some said, give me your address, we'll take care of you. Went into their own kick, paid full shipping, and sent me entire lines. And I don't forget that as a Sicilian. And Lorenzo Villarisi was one of the houses that took care of me and sent me their entire line. And I was blown away for two reasons. First, these were very simple and classic fragrances within the house. You know, you've got Sandolo and Musk and Patchouli. But then there were also more complicated fragrances like Uomo, Spiette, Tintinege, and far and away my favorite, a fragrance called Piper Nigrum. Before we talk about Piper Nigrum, let's talk about the house for a bit. Lorenzo Villarisi, house that was founded in 1990 by the perfumer. He had traveled to the Middle East earlier in his life, really looked at that as sort of a watershed moment for him. Got to smell the spices and materials, and when he came back to Italy, he started making potpourris and fragrances. He had a very small line going in 1990. The first order for the products, which included room sprays, was from the house of Fendi. Villarisi also worked as a perfumer and consultant for houses like Chanel and Hermes, so very familiar with larger designer houses and what they want and are looking for. Besides being a perfumer, Villarisi has written several books about perfumery in Italian. The most well-known probably being El Profumo, Cultura e Storia, and Tecnica. He also spends a lot of time just promoting the culture of fragrance. He does conferences in Italy every year. He helped to found the Academy of Perfume Arts in Florence. And for his contributions to the world of fragrance, he received the prestigious Prix Francois Coty Award in 2006. That's sort of like a lifetime achievement award in the fragrance industry. And I think the most recent fragrance Villarisi has done is Museo for Gucci. I actually don't love that one. That's a boutique exclusive. I didn't really like that one too much, but you know, what are you going to do? It's called Museo, I think. And you know, that happens. You're not going to love everything that a perfumer does. I didn't like that one that much, but I'm a huge fan of Piper Nigrum, and that's a fragrance we'll be talking about today. Lorenzo Villarisi isn't the easiest house to find. You know, there are a few shops that have it, including his website. Perfume Shop is another one, and Lafco sells them as well. In New York City, I might be wrong, but I think the only place that I know for sure sells Villarisi is Santa Maria Novella in the Soho Nolita area. So when I went there a couple of weeks ago to get Acqua di Tima by Oda Italy, I grabbed a 50ml of Piper Nigrum for $90. There are also 100ml bottles of this floating around for $130. This was released in 1999 as a unisex fragrance. As far as your presentation goes, really simple box, Lorenzo Villarisi, Piper Nigrum, Eau de Toilette, information on the bottom, information on the, I actually ripped the top a little bit, on the back. As far as your bottle goes, really, really simple, sort of like the Artisan in that it's got that hexagon shape, Lorenzo Villarisi on the cap. Firenze, it says, and a very nice sprayer which has some resistance so you can really control your sprays, and its sticker, Lorenzo Villarisi Piper Nigrum. So very simple, elegant, sort of understated Italian presentation. And the name Piper Nigrum means black pepper. And notes on this fragrance are dill, wild anise, fennel, peppermint, citrus, green, and camphor nuances at the top. black pepper, oregano, nutmeg, elemi, olibanum, petitgrain, cloves, rosemary, and sea notes in the middle, and amber, styrax, benzoin, Peru balsam, myrrh, and atlas cedarwood in the base. So lots of notes in this fragrance, and most of them, or at least a lot of them, are fairly uncommon. And to me, guys, this is one of the best male fragrances of all time. Let me break it down for you like this. It is a completely original fragrance, and as a 1990 release, it is unbelievably ballsy. Imagine taking a 1980s hairy chest, hardcore, masculine fragrance like the original Polo Green and crossing that with a watery Jean-Claude Elena Hermes Jardin fragrance. That's what this is. At the top, it's an absolutely breathtaking combination of fennel, peppermint, oregano, and dill. And it's unreal. The first time I ever smelled this, I was blown away. I had never smelled anything like this. And it actually, I think it's better as it dries down. That black pepper starts to assert itself. As it gets drier, they start to get more bite to this fragrance. The herbs become toned down. You get some cloves and balsam wood. And then about hour six into the composition, that's when you're really going to get hit with the resins and the cedar wood. And it sort of smells ambery, like a herbal ambery base, if that makes sense. Just really perfectly composed and very Italian. This is something that an Italian, not an Italian American, but like a real wealthy Italian aristocrat would wear. This is for a man who desires the finer things, but is still willing to do his research and not get ripped off. And this at under $100 for a niche composition of this quality is unreal. And let me add this to the mix. Don't think that Villarisi is a one-trick pony. You know, down the road, I hope to introduce you folks to more from this very deserving house. Now, as far as who a fragrance like this will fit, very masculine. One of the few scents that I think it would be almost impossible for a chick to pull off, but go for it. You know, everyone's different. Everyone has their own taste. For me, this is for a mature man, a man who's confident, a man who doesn't care what other people think of him. Occasion-wise, I think work is fine if you're light on the trigger, but I also think this would be a great upper-class scent. If you have a big party to go to, this does wonders with a tuxedo. Can also be worn in any season, but for me, it's going to shine in the spring and fall. I think it can be worn in extreme temperatures, but in summer, you got to be careful with it. It is an eau de toilette concentration, but I get absolutely fantastic projection and longevity out of Piper Nigrum. 10 hours is about normal, and I get great projection for about 7 to 8 hours. To me, guys, this is a 9 out of 10 fragrance. You know, I have two minor criticisms, but they are indeed both minor. You know, I wish that Villarisi's fragrances would be easier to find. Especially that 100ml, which I probably would have bought if I had been able to find it in New York. And then the second thing, honestly, is I would have liked a little bit better of a presentation. I think that the juice is way more deserving. You know, it's a really regal scent, and I think it deserves a regal encasement. You know, unfortunately, the cap is very light. And there's not a ton of detail, but I said it is understated and simple in Italian. I think because of how high quality this juice is, it should be in a better vessel, but you know, that really is a minor gripe for me. It's fine as far as I'm concerned. That's a real nitpick. I would say that this is a phenomenal scent for men who love niche perfumery, for men who don't want to get the normal average thing, those freshies that are at the mall, the Acqua di Gio's and the Cool Waters and all that bullshit. And those do have their place. Don't get me wrong. You know, I own Cool Water. I'm going to be buying Acqua di Gio, so they do have their place. You know, women do love those. But this is a man's fragrance, and it's a man's fragrance without being sort of those overpowering, 80s big time fragrances. This is more simple and more discreet, but still absolutely fantastic. Anyway, hope you have enjoyed this episode of Maximilian Must Know. We will be back for 2 weeks next week. Please check out my blog at maximilianmustknow.com. I'll see you guys. So what you check out me for? Not a condom pop. Said, so what, Cam? Your nasty ass didn't stop. So? Your nasty ass didn't even. Then ask, who's your little friend? I like to meet her. Hey, girl. I'm